Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic, coming to you directly from my home. I'm about to show you how to predict the future. That's right, when you learn this card trick, you're gonna be able to fool your friends, your family, and even your math teachers on this one. I've done this trick about 1,000 times to myself because it is so funny because it just looks like it shouldn't work at all. So grab a deck of cards and let's get started. Seriously, pause the video, grab a deck of cards. You're gonna be making choices on your side of the screen, and so this will not make sense if you just follow my side. So grab a deck of cards. Now, I'm gonna show you a move to make. This is our move, or what we could call our shuffle. Take a card from the top, and you're gonna place it on the bottom. That's it. Just, you can't take two, you can't take three, it definitely has to be one card from the top to the bottom. So when I say make a move or make a shuffle, it's really just one card to the bottom. That's it, that's all you have to know. The other thing is we're gonna be spelling out words, and for every letter, we're gonna make a move. So as we spell out the word, every letter requires one card from the top to the bottom. Now, you're gonna be making choices. You get to pick which pile you pick up for each letter, but for every letter, one card moves from the top to the bottom. We're gonna need 8 cards. Grab 4 cards from, let's say, the hearts. That'll be easy for you guys to follow along with that. And I'm gonna use 4 cards from the diamonds. So 4, 3, 2, ace on one side, put them in descending order so that the 4 will be on top when I flip them over. And ace, 2, 3, 4 on the other side so that the ace is on top in the other pile. Now, when you do this effect to your friends and family, they don't need to see the setup. In fact, you could just say, I'm making a prediction of how this is gonna work. Now, today's secret magical words, it's math or magic. That's right. Math or magic, all of them together. And we're gonna spell them out, and you get to pick up which pile you want for each letter. So you don't have to follow my lead on this, just every time you spell a new letter, flip one card from the tops. So let's get started. M-A-T-H-O-R-M-A-G-I-C. All right, now, I put the piles down. I'm gonna take the top card from each pile. I'm gonna place it at the top, right here, just away from them. So now we only have 3 cards on each side. So let's spell math or magic again. So here we go. M-A-T-H, you can do it in any order you want. O-R-M-A-G-I-C. All right, now take the top card from each pile. Set them aside together. Now, we have 2 cards on each side, so one last time, let's do it. M-A-T-H-O-R-M-A-G-I-C. Top cards, place it together. Now, we could do it again, but we only have 1 card each, so let's just slide those together. Now, you could have made any choice you wanted. You could have grabbed this pile or that pile, and you could have spelled it out any way you chose. But if you look closely, take a look at these 2 cards. How amazing is that those 2 cards matched up? And if we take a close look at these 2, they matched up. And the next 2, they matched up. And the last ones, they matched up. That is unbelievable. You could have done any choice, left or right, and yet you predicted the future by setting up the cards that way. Now, if that just blew your mind, type in the word magic below in the comments. And if you want to understand how this is done, I'll give you a hint. It's mathematics. And it was created by a mathematical wizard slash mathematician slash genius, Martin Gardner. And if you want to learn more about Martin Gardner, I'll put some links to his books below because they're amazing. Now, you have a choice. You can just remember how to set this up, remember all the steps, and you'll be able to do this to your friends and your family, and it will be magical to them and you because you won't understand the math behind it. And you can forever see magic. Or you can see part 2 of this video. I'm gonna break this down step by step so that you can actually see the inner workings of this magic trick. But spoiler alert, I'm gonna ruin the magic part. So that choice is up to you. And if you had fun today, let me know by clicking the like button and subscribing to the channel. And until next time, stay curious. Because the right question changes everything. Hey guys, it's Jason Latimer, the world champion of magic, coming to you directly from my home. Now we're doing part two of the math or magic card trick. Now that means if you just stumbled across this video by accident, then stop the video and go back and watch part one of math or magic, because we're just going over the math and the explanation of how it worked. All right, in our setup, we had ace, two, three, and four. And over here, we had four, three, two, and ace. They alternated in patterns. One was ascending, one was descending, all right? But when we said shuffle the cards, or when I told you what the move was, we were really just moving one card to the bottom every single time. The funny thing about this situation is the cards really aren't changing order. They're just rotating which card you start on. See, if I were to arrange these like in the shape of a clock, we weren't really changing the order. We were just making one go down to the bottom and the order stayed the same. Now, another thing is a little experiment we can do with you guys here. I'll just make it more like what we saw earlier. This is the genius of Martin Gardner to set it up this way, where ace, two, three, four has a special relationship to the cards that are four, three, two, ace. And it's that all these cards match up by three moves. What does that mean? It means if you were to put your finger on these top cards, so I spread them out as the first card, second card, third card, fourth card. If I said make three moves, there's no way you can move without lining up cards. Watch. One, two, three. The fours match up. Here, I'll do it again. One, two, three. The threes match up. I can even flip it around. One, two, three. The twos match up. In fact, as long as the left side and the right side, if the left side and the right side equal three moves, then you have the same card. Now, I know there's gonna be a lot of different ways to do this mathematically, but not everybody's in algebra, so I'm gonna just break it down step by step. Now, in this case, we can also say, what happens if we just said the right side was zero turns, so you did all your moves on one side? Well, it works because you could say L was three times. One, two, three, they match up. What happens at the fourth move? Well, they don't match, but what it does do is it puts us right back at the beginning where we started. So every four moves, one, two, three, four, we're back where we started. That means there's really nothing different. So you could say, three plus four moves puts us right back where we started. Let's see if that works. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven. They match. Well, three plus four equals seven. Same card. But that's also true if we just keep adding four each time. So you could say three plus four, back up here, plus another four. One, two, three, four, you're back up there. So it'll also work for 11. It will also work for 3 plus 4 plus 4 plus 4. It'll also work for 15. Okay? So that means if I said move three moves, they'll line up. So 1, 2, 3. If I said move seven moves, they'll line up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It also works for 11, and it also works for 15, and it can go on and on and on as long as you just keep adding four to that number. So let's try three cards, because when we did this trick, we actually removed a card after we paired them up. Well, the relationship between this pile and this pile is only two cards. So let's try it out. One, two. The relationship between these, one, two. Try it again, one, two. L plus R equals two, then we know we have the same card. But we also know at three moves, we're back where we started again, just like we did up here. So we can say two plus three equals five, and at five moves, you have the same card again. Let's try it out. One, two, three, four, five, matching pair. This also means at two plus three, you have a matching pair, but you can also add another three. At eight moves, we have the same card again. That also means that 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus another 3, at 11 moves we have a matching card. And it also means that 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3. If you keep going with this, you can also say that it meets up at 14 cards and 17 cards, and as long as I keep adding 3 to this situation, they match up. So let's take a look at 2 cards. At 2 cards, it's starting to get really simple. In one move, they match up. You could do it this way, or you could add 2 plus 1. So let's just get started with this. So 2 cards. If L plus R equals one move, if I move them once, they line up. Well, we also know that after one move, at 2 moves, we're back at the beginning again. So we could say 1 plus 2 equals 3. So at 3 moves, we're gonna find the same card. Let's try it. 1, 2, 3, same card. So we can keep doing that. We can say 1 plus 2 plus 2 equals 5. We'll find the same card. 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 equals 7. You'll find the same card. 1 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 equals 9. And you can just keep doing this on and on. Plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 equals 11. And you can do it one more time for good luck. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 equals 13. All right, so we now know that if we were to do these number of moves for 2 cards, we'll find the same card. Or if we only had 3 cards and we did one of these, we'd find the same card. If we did one of these, we'd find the same card. And if you look over all these answers, there's one answer that solves the issues of all 3 different situations. In mathematics, we would call this solving 3 equations at the same time. This is a magic number. You've probably already spotted it at home. But the number 11 solves the equation for 4 cards. And the number 11 solves the problem with 3 cards, and number 11 solves the problem with 2 cards. Now let's take a look at our magic word, math or magic. Count them out. M-A-T-H-O-R-M-A-G-I-C. That's 11 moves. And 11 works for all 3 scenarios. Now, Martin Gardner did this with the word abracadabra. That's if you can spell abracadabra. I just went with the words math or magic. Now, you can try to do this with 5 cards. In fact, you can just keep doing this with more and more cards, but you have to do the math to figure out when they will all line up again with the same magic word. If you did this with 5 cards, you're gonna need a magic word or sentence that equals 59 letters. That's a very, very long word. The great part about this magic trick is that it uses mathematics, and the math will always be true. No matter how many choices you make, no matter how many times you zigzag between one pile and the other pile, the math will always work. That's the great part about math, is it's always true. So, the choice is up to you. If you like seeing the mathematics side of this magic trick, let me know in the comments below. And if you don't, if you want to see the magic side, just let me know in the comments below. Until next time, stay curious, because the right question changes everything.